Hey, what God would promise, he will bring to pass.
Yes.
I mean, realize that God is an awesome God.
Yes.
So we find out that Joseph said, they are my sons whom God had given me in this land.
Well,
how many of you able to give birth in a drought?
Yes.
Got no help now. You able to give help in a drought. And to magnify the favor as I need it. How many know I heard something this week that blew my mind? Have you ever heard of magnified grace? Magnified grace. Woo! Magnified means to make large. But some of the things we mixed up in and messed up in and got stuck in, God has gave us favor. Some of the stuff we've been through should have killed us. How many of some people are going through the stuff you go through and end up in this terrible state? But God not only kept you, but he kept your mind. My God, he's kept your health. Some of y'all know you was a mess in the world. You used to drink every day, was alcoholic and strung out, and you ain't got no ailments now. Tell your neighbor, God is able to give you the exit. It's going to make some sense in a minute in hell. Y'all pushing me. I hear you. I feel you. But how many realize that Joseph brought his son to Israel? And Israel, Joseph had him between his knees and he said, Daddy, as Daddy was sitting beside the bed, as I press on now, as Daddy was sitting beside the bed, and beside the bed, Joseph takes his oldest son, Manasseh, and he put Manasseh in the right hand that faces Israel's right hand. He put Ephraim, a man that faces Israel's left hand. So in essence is that Manasseh should have got the blessing because he was the eldest son. But how many realize but a mix up? Because he couldn't see. And he thought that he forgot what he was doing. But when he realized that, but how many realize but the old man had one more trick for him? But the old man brought the kids before him. How many know he crossed his hands? He laid his right hand on the left side. And he laid his left hand on the right side. How many know when Joseph realized that, wait a minute, Daddy, you messed up. You mixing them up. That ain't the right way to go. He said, son, I know. How many know your mix up? Say, I might be mixed up, but I'm not messed up. I might not be able to see, but I know what God is able to do. Yeah. Here come the woman down to the well. Oh Lord, how many know she was mixed up, Karen, and messed up. But when she got to the well to draw some water, Jesus said, I got to go through Samaria. How many know that Jesus put himself in your way so you could ask him something? He said, woman, was messed up, but God gonna turn it around for her. He told the woman, woman, I got some water that you can drink that you'll never go dry. She said, I'm mixed up, man. You ain't got nothing to throw with. I don't see no bucket in your hand. He said, I don't need no bucket. I am the lady of the valley.
Yeah!
than your pastor gave you now. Some of y'all be saying, I ain't crazy. Like, I can talk to my shit. But now you got to say, I might be mixed up. My life has been messed up. My children are messed up. But God said that ain't a mess up. That's a mix up. Yeah. And when God started adding stuff to your mixing, yeah. I know what he produces. Yeah. You need to realize what's already in you. Yeah. Somebody that got joy in you, awesome. But you don't even realize it yet. Yeah. There is some possibilities in a whole lot of y'all. But today, I really tried to teach it here. But today, at the end of the conclusion, Israel tells Joseph, he said, Joseph, I know, but the younger shall be greater than the oldest one. I can go on home now and be with the Lord. Good God Almighty, because God has been good to me. My son, who I thought was dead and gone, has returned to me. God has been real good to me. How many can say that? When I look back over my life and see what the Lord has done for me, I can say, Lord, you it's part of the mixture.
It's part of the mixture.
God. Tell you that you ain't messed up.
You ain't messed up.
You might be married to Mr. Hale.
All right.
But you ain't messed up.
You ain't messed up.
You might be married to Miss Hale.
All right.
But you ain't messed up.